relax, enjoy the beautiful day, and please welcome Verlon Thompson and Shawn Camp with the songs of Guy Clark.
What do you want to kick off with, Frank?
Where's the fiddle? Where's the fiddle? Where's that fiddle at?
Well, you're more fiddle.
Okay. My next question is, where's Jim Lauderdale? You and Jim ran off with that one.
You told me you wasn't going to start till I got back.
I didn't.
Oh, that coffee's good.
What you got, Verlon?
Well, I thought maybe we'd just sit here for a while and sing a bunch of Guy Clark songs. Probably a good place to start would be when he was about 6 years old. Out there in Monahans, Texas. And
I'm ready.
The rumor was there's a big train coming through town, and apparently Guy was a smartass even when he was 6 years old. And he said, why do we need to go down and watch a train come through? I've seen a lot of trains come through this town. They said, you ain't seen one like this. This is one of them streamlined trains. Oh, I don't need it for this.
You don't need it? Did I start it or did
you
start?
Yeah, you started.
Now, being 6 years old, I had seen some trains before. It's hard to figure out what I'm at the depot for. Trains are big and black and smoking steam, screaming at the wheels. Bigger than anything they is, at least that's the way she feels. Trains are big and black and smoking, lighter than July 4. Everybody's acting like this could be something more than just picking up the mail
or the soldiers from the war. This is something even old man Wildman never seen before. It's a late afternoon on a hot Texas day, and something strange is going on, and we's all in the way. Now there's 50, 60 people sitting on their cars. The old men left their dominoes and they come down from the bars, and everybody's watching. Old Jack Kid from Texas watch, and us kids put our ears to the rails to hear them call. So we already know them. Finally said train time. You'd have thought that Jesus Christ himself was rolling down the line.
Got real quiet, Mama jerked me back. Not before I got the church on the track. Woo! Look out, here she goes, he's coming. Look out, there she goes, she's gone. Screaming straight through Texas like a mad dog psycho. Big red and silver, she don't make no smoke. She's a fast rolling streamline. Show you.
Sitting on their cars, and everybody's wondering just how he got this car.
But me, I got a nickel smash flatter than a dime. I'm that dog, runaway red silver straight line train. Look out, here she comes, she's coming. Look out, there she goes, she's gone. Screaming straight through Texas like a mad dog cyclone. Baby red and silver, she don't make no smoke. She lay fast, rolling streamline. Come show you. I said, look out, here she comes, she's coming. Look out, there she goes, she's gone. Screaming straight through Texas like a mad dog cyclone.
Part of this whole thing is it ain't just singing guys' songs, it's telling some stories, because Shawn and I both, we spent a lot of time in the trenches with Guy Clark. We spent time on the road with him, we spent time writing songs with him, hanging out down in his workshop, spent time in the studio recording with him, and we figured if anybody can tell stories about Guy Clark from the inside point of view, it ought to be us. So I was going to tell you something that struck me is that it's funny, because when I was 6 years old, my granddad bought me an old guitar, and he said, son, I'm going to give you this guitar, but you're going to have to learn to play my favorite song. I said, what's your favorite song, granddad? He said, well, my favorite song is called Red River Valley. So I learned to play the Red River Valley when I was about 7 years old. And who would ever believe that 30-something years later I'd hook up with an old boy whose life was also touched by that same song and by another old man that asked him to learn it. And we played it every night.
Desperados waiting for a train.
tobacco stains all down his chin. But to me, he's one of the heroes of this country. So why is he all dressed up like an old man? Drinking beer, playing moon in 42. Up a kitchen, sang another verse to that old song.
Come on, Jack, son of a bitch is coming. Texas and out west, the western part of Texas, but he didn't always live out west in Monahan. Where was he?
Yeah, he moved down to South Texas, down on the Gulf. He moved down to Rockport, Texas, when he was, I don't know, a young man, a teenager. I think he went to high school down there. And he fell in love with the water. He told me, he said he loved to get out there, and he did some work on them old shrimp boats there in the harbor, and his one of his high school buddies told me the guy used to water ski over to his high school every morning. His buddy had a boat, and he'd pull up, and guy would be standing there in his skis, and he'd just grab the rope, and he'd tow him down there and let him go, and guy would just ski right up on the shore and walk right into school.
Probably smoking a cigarette all
the time. Probably smoking a cigarette the whole time. I bet he did. So, yeah. Here's a story about that.
Well, the South Coast of Texas is a thin slice of life. It's salty and hard, and it's stern as a knife. Where the wind is for blowing up, hurricanes for showing, snakes how to swim, and the trees how to lean. And the shrimpers and their ladies are out in the beer joints, dragging them down for they sail with the dawn. They're bound for the Mexican Bay of Campeche, and the deckhands are singing adios, Jolie Pond.
Now them snowbirds in search of that sunshine in the nightlife. Fond of grease and palms down the breeze as they're going. All this living on the edge of the waters of the world demands the dignity of whooping cranes and the likes of Gilbert Rowland. And the strippers and their ladies are out in the beer joints, cranking them down before they sail with the dawn. They're bound for the Mexican Bay of Camp PJ, and the deckhands are singing adios, strolling along.
In the cars of my youth, I tore down those sand dunes, cut up my tires on them oyster shell roads. Oh, but nothing is forever, say the old man in the shipyard, turning trees into shrimp boats. Hell, I guess they ought to know. And the shrimpers and their ladies are out in the beer joints, cranking them down before they sail with the dawn. They're bound for the Mexican Bay of Camp PJ, and the deckhands are singing adios.
Story about guys' comfort, I'll put it that way. A guy was comfortable in the water and on the rough seas. And I learned about that one time. We took a trip to the Bahamas. The richest woman in Texas hired us. Richest woman in Texas hired us to come and play for her birthday party. She wanted Guy Clark to be her birthday gift. And so there we went. We went to Miami and they picked us up on a helicopter and they flew us down to one of those islands. I can't remember which one. But we landed and looked over there and there's about a 100-foot yacht. It's made all out of mahogany and teak wood and it had brass and chrome all over it, and it was a partying barge is what it was. So that's what we did that night. We played and we partied and had fun. And we got up the next day to leave because Guy and I had another show, and overnight a big storm had blown in. High winds. We looked out across the water and the waves were as tall as this building. And I thought, well, we ain't going nowhere today. The helicopters can't get in to get us, so we got a day off. I headed back to my room, and pretty soon I heard a knock on my door. Verlon, get your ass out here. I hitched us a ride. Turns out he had hitched us a ride, all right. He hitched us a ride on a little old shrimp boat that was leaving that island and was going across the water there and was headed for West Palm Beach. So me and Guy threw our guitars on this little boat and we took off across those rough waters. And like I said, those waves were 20 feet tall and we'd go straight up one side of it and then hit the crest and we'd fall down the other side and go straight down. And I was in the cabin trying to hang on to our guitars and I was throwing up, turning white. I was about to lose my mind and I started looking around wondering where in the hell is Guy Clark? And I looked back there and you know on the back of these boats they have that nice, kind of like a dentist chair sitting on the back of the boat where you strap yourself in, and Guy had strapped himself into that recliner back there and was asleep. His old head was just flopping back and forth. He's sleeping like a baby, and I was up there throwing up and everything. Anyway, we made it. We made it to West Palm Beach. Records, and that was a really big thrill for me. And a few years later, Jimmy Buffett and Alan Jackson did a duet of it, and that was another big thrill for me. But I guess the biggest thrill that ever really came out of that song was one day when I went to the mailbox. Now, I know what you're thinking. You're thinking royalty checks, but that ain't it. It's much better than that. I opened up the mailbox and there was a brown envelope in there, Sean. It had the return address said Key West on it. I didn't really know anybody in Key West, so I wondered what the hell this was. But I opened it up, and what it was a snapshot that somebody had taken of an old wooden, weather-beaten, faded gray wall that looked like it might be on a dock or a pier somewhere. And this person had taken a big old thick paintbrush and some dark blue paint, climbed up on a ladder, and started painting the lyrics to this song on that wall. Started up here in the upper left-hand corner, and he started painting big old letters. Came back, kept going. But the most beautiful part was when he got down into the bottom left-hand corner of this picture, there was an old Coke machine sitting there, all rusted and busted up. Tell it had been there for many years. When he got there, he just painted the lyrics right across the Coke machine. And I thought, man, that's so cool, because you could tell it's been there a while, nobody ever moved the Coke machine because they didn't want to destroy the lyric. And something about that just hit me. I stood there at the end of my driveway and I cried like a baby looking at that picture, thinking, man, you don't know where these songs are going to go when you release them. You don't know who they're going to touch or what they might compel somebody to do. Now shore, distant shore, see there, that's what I'm headed for. I'll let the stars guide my way, then sail into the light of day. I'm gonna build me a boat with these two hands, a fair curve from a noble land. I'll let the chips fall. Y'all probably read the book. I ain't read that book yet. But I know he did. He went to L.A. and he told me. Did he tell you this story about how he wrote this?
Yeah, but I mean, you're going to have to tell it. Like he did it. When he told me. Let's play the song. You tell the story where he told me. You want to do that?
Oh, I mean, no. The other song about, I mean, the other story about the...
Oh, the hamburger bag? Yeah. I don't know. Go ahead.
Well, a guy said he was driving around on the L.A. freeway and he was trying to get off at an exit, and every time he'd get to that exit, somebody would cut him off and he'd have to go around the loop again. And
stuck on a clover leaf.
Stuck on one of those things. He said he went around about three times and he finally just said out loud, he said, man, if I could just get off of this damn freeway without getting killed or caught. And Susanna looked at him and handed him her mascara pencil, and they grabbed a burger sack out of the back seat and wrote it down on the burger sack right there.
Landlord for me, son of a bitch has always
dirt road back street. If I can just get off of this L.A. freeway without getting killed or caught, I'll be down that road in a cloud of smoke to some land. I ain't bought, bought, bought.
Here's to you, old skinny Dennis. Only one I think I will miss. I can hear that old bass singing, sweet and low like the gift you're bringing. So play it for me one more time now. Got to give it all we can now. I believe everything you're saying. Just to keep on, keep on.
Got something to believe in. Don't you think it's time you're leaving?
Put the pink card in the mailbox. Leave the key in that old front door lock. They're gonna find it likely as not. I'm sure there's something we have.
Story about the little apartment they lived in out there in L.A. He said it just a little one-room apartment, and he said right out the front window there's a prettiest little grapefruit tree you've ever seen in your life, growing right outside the front window. But he said the landlord of this place was one of those guys. He was a little bit different. He said he was one of those guys that would come home from work every day, go out to the garage, and make his own bullets. That may be strange to some of you, not so strange to others. But it concerned Guy. Especially the day he came home and he saw that neighbor or that landlord out there in the front yard with a big old axe getting ready to chop down the grapefruit tree. The guy said he walked up to him real carefully and said, "Hey man, what are you doing?" The old boy said, "Well, Guy," he said, "this old grapefruit tree, it's been here so long, it's grown up so tall. It's spread out so wide." He said, "It's starting to crack my concrete patio." That's what the guy said.
"Pack up all your dishes. Make note of all good wishes. Say goodbye. Always born me.
where's that Key West? You didn't send me that picture, did you? You're not the Key West person that sent me a picture. All right. Just checking. I know what you're doing there. I don't know if we know that one. Ain't nothing sweeter than a watermelon dream. Sitting on the front porch eating that peach ice cream.
When life is...
And life is just sweet as it seems. I can't remember it. Yeah, we'll have to Google it. You know, it's funny, all these songs, I stood there beside Guy for 1,000 shows and played along with him, and I could sing every word, but then when somebody asked me to sing one of his songs, I can't come up with the word. It's crazy. I'm some of them I can, but the, you know, like Watermelon Dream, I should know that song.
Yeah.
And I promise you, the next time I will. Yeah, there's a bunch more we're gonna do, but old Shawn busted his finger.
Yeah,
here. We're
right in the middle of that one. I had to play that whole song with the wrong fingernail. Thank you.
Everything there is to do. He worked on freighters, he worked on bars, he worked on farms, he worked on cars. It was white port that put that look in his eye that most men get when they need to cry, and he just sat down on the curb to rest, and his head just fell down on his chest. He said every single day it gets a little bit harder to handle, and yet then he lost the thread and his mind got cluttered and the words just rolled off down the gutter. He's an elevator man in a cheap hotel in exchange for the rent on a one-room cell, and he's old years beyond his time thanks to the world and the white port wine. He says, son, he always called me son. He said, life for you has just begun. And he told me a story I'd heard before about how he fell in love with a Dallas whore. He could cut through the years to the very night when it ended in a whorehouse fight. She turned his last proposal down in favor of being a girl about town. Been 17 years right in line, and he ain't been straight none of the time. Too many days of fighting the weather, too many nights of not being together. So he died. From the welfare checks, there was a crumbling picture of a girl in a door, in a dress in Dallas and nothing more. The welfare people provided the priest, and the couple from the mission up the street sang Amazing Grace, and no one cried except some lady in black way off to the side. Well, we all left
She's standing there with that black veil covering her silver hair. And old One-Eyed John said her name was Alice. Said she used to be a whore in Dallas. So let him roll. Oh, let him roll. Betty, she's gone to Dallas. Rest his soul.
Been to the Chili Parlor bar down in Austin. Hey there! He got the t-shirt.
Texas Chili.
All right. Did you have you a Mad Dog margarita? Yeah.
You was got it wonderful, or was it the worst one you've ever had? Was it the last one?
Well, that was the deal. Guy said him and Towns used to go in there and order a margarita, but they didn't have much money, so the guy would put the cheapest ingredients that he had. And that's, to this day, they still make a Mad Dog margarita. It's as shitty as they can make it. And we got somebody that can testify right now.
It's cheap mezcal they use.
Yeah.
Yeah. But you gotta have one if you go.
Yep. You got to.
You owe it to Guy.
I was told on the day he died when the word got out that the Chili Parlor bar was absolutely packed to the rim. Everybody drinking them bad.
Is that right?
Yeah. Yeah.
They had to send out for refreshment and food.
Is that right?
Were you there?
He said they ran out of
margarita
mix at noon. That's great. Guy would love that.
Y'all help us sing this one.
Well, I wished I was in Austin. In a Chili Parlor bar, drinking Mad Dog margaritas and not caring where you are. But here I sit in Dublin, just a rolling cigarettes, holding back and choking back the shakes with every breath. So forgive me all my anger, forgive me all my faults. There's no need to forgive me for thinking what I thought. I loved you from the get-go, and I'll love you till I die. I loved you on the Spanish steps the day you said goodbye. Thank you. just a poor boy. Works my middle name. If money was the reason, hell, I would not be the same. But I'll stand up and be counted. I'll face up to the truth. I'll walk away from trouble, but I can't walk away from you. So forgive me all my anger, forgive me all my faults. There's no need to forgive me for thinking what I thought. I love you from the get-go, and I'll love you till I die. I love you on the Spanish steps the day you said goodbye.
Vanilla tastes so sweet, he called it pine. I know a woman cooked bad dudes, it tastes so good to get you high. Get them enchiladas greasy, get them steaks chicken fried. Sure do make a man feel happy to see white gravy on the side. Fried okra, beat anything that you ever saw. And I know a man that cook copper rico. It must be against the law. We're gonna get a big old sausage, big old plate of ranch style bean. I could eat the heart of Texas, but we're gonna need some brand new cheese.
Oh, my mama, ain't that Texas cooking something? Oh, my mama's got the old belly and backbone for pumping.
Just you. your side and find I hadn't lied about nothing. I wouldn't trade a tree for the way I feel about you in the morning. Anyhow, I love you.
Song, I have have that little catch in my throat, because there's a spot in this song where a guy always used to look me dead in the eye every time that line came around, and so today I'm awful glad to be able to look Shawn Camp right in the eye when that line comes
back at you.
I got an old blue shirt, suits me just fine. I like the way it feels and I wear it all the time. I got an old guitar and won't ever stay in tune. I like the way it sounds in a dark and empty room.
I got an old pair of boots and they fit just right. I can work all day and I can dance all night. I got an old used car and it runs just like a top. I get the feeling it ain't ever gonna stop.
Oh, yeah.
Stuff that works, stuff that holds up, the kind of stuff don't hang on the wall. Stuff that's real, stuff you feel, the kind of stuff you reach for when you fall.
Big one, y'all. Pretty good friend, and he's seen me at my worst. He can't tell if I'm a blessing or a curse.
But he always shows up when the chips are down. That's the kind of stuff I like to be around.
Hey,
got a tattoo with her name right
scratches turns to gold.
Of that kind of stuff that works. A few years ago, I fell off of my roof and I broke both of my arms. And yeah, that ain't stuff that works, but they patched me up and they sent me home from the hospital, and I had these wire cages around my arms, and I was taking all these pretty powerful pain pills, you know. So I was unconscious for about 6 weeks. And one morning, I finally opened one of my eyes, and I looked up, and I thought for sure I must be hallucinating, because I looked up, and I could see, I thought I was seeing like a smoky haze above me, and then I thought I could see Guy Clark's silhouette staring down at me through the smoke. And so I kept rubbing my eyes and trying to clear my head a little bit. Finally, it occurred to me that this ain't no hallucination. That is Guy Clark's silhouette. He had come to visit me. And it was a smoky haze, in fact. Because as you do when you go visit the sick and afflicted, you fire up a cigarette. Hover over them, and you blow smoke rings. And you flick the ashes in their living room floor.
He enjoyed doing it.
He loved it. Anyway, I laid there in this kind of a peeled up state of mind thinking, man, what's he gonna say? It seemed like it took forever for him to say something. And if you know anything about Guy Clark, you know that he gets right down to the heart of every matter. He didn't bullshit around. He had this way of cutting right to the heart of everything. And on this occasion, he didn't let me down. It took him a while, but finally when he spoke, he said, "You didn't trust your cape, did you?" Trust you can't.
grown up with that flour sack cape tied all around his dreams. He's full of piss and vinegar, and he's busting at the seams. So he licks his finger and checks the wind. He says it's gonna be do or die. And he wasn't scared of nothing, y'all. He's pretty sure he could fly. 'Cause he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your cane. Tied all around his head. He's still jumping off the garage and will be till he's dead. You see, all these years of people saying he is acting like a kid. Well, he did not know that he could not fly, so he did. 'Cause you see, he's one of those who knows that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your cane. Be one of those who know that life is just a leap of faith. Spread your arms and hold your breath and always trust your cane. Spread your arms and hold your breath, y'all, and always trust your cane. Kidding, Sean, but as soon as I kicked that song off, I watched a guy fall out of his hammock right back up there. Really? I don't know where he went. He's still up there, but he tried to up and he slipped and he fell right
on his... hit the ground?
On his back. And he laid there a minute and kicked his legs and then stood up. And
sometimes when you trust it, you still bust your rear.
Yeah, I know, yeah. It doesn't say trust your hammock, does it? It says cake.
Hey, man, dump another.
What do we got here?
How about the Randall Knife there? You want that?
Yeah, I'll try.
Is that the C?
I do it. I guess it don't matter, really.
Where do you do it?
I do it in D.
All right.
Hell, it's a talking song. It don't matter what key it's in. Why don't you play it and I'll talk?
I don't know if I can. I need you to play it too.
It's just like the other one. Guy always said it. The two of them songs are the same.
It's like Let It Roll.
Let Him Roll, yeah. Anyway, this is a tune that, and this is another one of those I get a catch in my throat because this is a tune Guy said he wrote on the occasion of his father's death. Lawyer by his trade, and only once did I ever see him misuse that blade. It almost cut his thumb off when he took it for a tool. You see, the knife was made for darker things, and you could not bend the rules. Well, he let me take it camping once on this Boy Scout jamboree. broke a half an inch off trying to stick it in a tree. I hid it from him for a while, but the knife and he were one. He put it in his bottom drawer without a hard word one. There it slept and there it stayed for 20 some odd years. Sort of like Excalibur, except waiting for a tear. Find a way to cry. Not because he didn't love me, not because I didn't try. I'd cried for every lesser thing, whiskey, pain, and beauty. But he deserved a better tear, and I was not quite ready. So we took his ashes out to sea and we poured them off the stern, and we threw those ashes in the wake of everything we'd learned. And when we got back to the house, they asked me what I wanted. I said, not the law books, not the watch. I need that thing he's haunted. My hand burned for that Randall knife there in the bottom drawer, and I found a tear for my father's life. All that it stood for. I insisted that Shawn knew. That's why we got an hour and a half to do this thing, because I said, I ain't doing it again unless Shawn has time to do this whole segment of tunes that he and Guy worked on about this old gal by the name of Sis Draper.
Now, Sis was really a fiddle player, and I knew her when I was a little boy. And my grandpa and my Uncle Cleve used to just light up when they'd talk about Sis Draper, you know. And I was just learning how to play mandolin and guitar a little bit back then. And, they said, boy, you're really going to have to get to practicing if you're going to play with Sis when she comes through. And she showed up with a big beehive hairdo carrying a fiddle. And I thought she was a superstar. And anyway. Shoes off in the corner, mama tucked them babies all up slow. Sis Draper's coming over and we all gonna cut her up. When you see that lantern swinging yonder coming up the holler road, them dogs will get to barking, ought to time all up with a rope. Don't shoot no dice or get too tired if you're gonna be with Sis tonight. Well, she came down from the Boston Mountains. There was lightning in the air, honey, on them fiddle strings. A magnolia hit her hair. Now she's a diamond in the rough. If you can't see the shine, that's tough. She'll play all night for the likes of us. Sis Draper's got the dust. stepped right up and sawed one off, and Uncle Cleve dropped his jaw. He said, "She's the best I ever saw. She must be from Arkansas." Well, I think Grandpa used to date her. Grandma says she still hates her, and all the fellas stand up straighter in the presence of Sis Draper. Punch if you spike it, sis don't care. Who don't like it? See, old sis got a hell of a bow arm on her. Well, she put her fiddle in a box and said it's getting awful late. She is on her way to Little Rock, and Little Rock can't wait. So we all stood out in the yard, hands all full of watermelon. Watched her leave and watched her go, wishing we was in that wagon. Sis Draper is the devil's daughter, plays a fiddle daddy bought her, plays it like her mammy taught her. She's a traveling Arkansas.
Then I heard them write Magnolia Wind. I said, man, what are y'all going to do next? Here's what they did next.
First I thought a snake had got me. It happened lightning quick. But it was a bullet bit my leg and right off I got sick. Came to end a wagon load of 10 more wounded men. 9 was dead by the time we reached that bloody 10. Give me some of that soldier's joy, you know what I mean. I don't wanna hurt no more, my leg is turning green. Well, the doctor come and he looked at me, and this is what he said. He said, your dancing days are done, son. It's a good thing you ain't dead. Then he went to work with the carving knife. Sweat fell from his brow. About killed me trying to save my life when he cut that lip all out. Give me some of that soldier's joy. You know what I like. Bear down on that fiddle, boy, just like Saturday night. Dripping down his apron strings like a river out the door. He handed me a bottle, said, son, drink deep as you can. He turned away, then he turned right back with a hacksaw in his hand. Give me some of that soldier's joy, you know what I crave. I'll be hitting that soldier's joy till I'm in my grave. Give me some of that soldier's.
This was a real special thing for us. Beth was nice enough to juggle the whole damn festival schedule so that we could have an hour and a half.
And we still running out of time. We still running out of time.
So we want to thank her for that. We want to thank the other bands up on the hill that had to wait a little longer to start. Thank y'all up there.